Hi, my name's Ed. Welcome to Ed Explains English, Life in the UK. What are you doing, Judy?
What I do every 1st of January. I'm transferring the diary entries from last year's to this.
If you did it digitally on your computer, like I do, there would be no need.
I still like the traditional way. If all the computers crash, I'll still know what I'm doing on March the 1st.
What's happening on March the 1st?
Well, it was just an example, but it's St David's Day, the national day in Wales, if you must know.
Wow, how do you know that?
Because it's written in my diary, Ed. I've got all the important days in there. Do you want me to go through them?
Well, it's raining outside and there's nothing to watch on the television, so why not?
OK, so the first traditional day of the year is Valentine's Day on February the 14th.
I got you some lovely roses last year, didn't I?
I think that was 2 years ago.
Oh, this year you will get roses and chocolates.
No chocolates. It's one of my New Year's resolutions.
Which traditionally you always break by the second week in January.
Not this year, Ed. I'm determined. The next tradition, which is very popular in this house, is Shrove Tuesday.
Ah yes, Pancake Day. I had an eating competition with the kids last year and I won. I ate 9 big pancakes.
Don't remind me. I had to listen to you complaining of stomachache all evening. In March and April, we have the Oxford versus Cambridge boat races on the Thames in London and the Grand National Horse Race at Aintree.
Always a chance for me to have a flutter on the nags, but I never win. You missed Ireland's St Patrick's Day on March the 17th and England's St George's Day on April the 23rd.
Oh yes, sorry. I missed Easter too. In the summer, the FA Cup final and Wimbledon are two big events on the sporting calendar. In the world of music, the Glastonbury Festival has become a traditional event for fans from all over the world.
Shame we can't get tickets anymore. When I went in 2005, I spent 3 days looking for my tent, paid sky-high prices for food, and watch musicians the size of matchsticks on the pyramid stage. Maybe it's better to watch it on the television anyway.
On October the 31st, we have Halloween, which has become a big tradition in recent years. A chance for young children to play trick-or-treat in their neighbourhood.
When I was a boy, it wasn't so popular because Guy Fawkes Day on November the 5th was all we had in mind. We used to make a puppet and collect money for fireworks.
Penny for the guy. I did it with my friends too. We used to raise enough money to buy one rocket, but our parents used to take us to an organised fireworks display in the park.
November the 30th is St Andrew's Day in Scotland. I'm good with the national days, aren't I?
Yes, you are, but you didn't know the Welsh one. The year ends with Christmas and the New Year's Eve celebrations.
Normally a hangover too. I'll make us a nice cup of tea.
We would like to thank you for watching this video. Visit Instagram where you can find complimentary vocabulary for this and our other videos. Please like, comment and share this video with your friends, as well as subscribing. Thanks for watching. Toodle-pip!